Hi guys, so this is Prateek Bhaiya from Coding Blocks, and I welcome you all to today's session on OpenCV. And in Python, we will be learning how to use OpenCV and build some interesting projects. I'm assuming you are already familiar with Python, or at least you will understand the syntax, what I am going to write. Okay, so I will directly start with OpenCV. And OpenCV is a library that is used to work with images in Python. So it provides a lot of image related operations, like you want to increase the brightness, or you want to increase the contrast, or you want to remove some kind of a noise pattern from the image, or you want to find out faces. All those things you can do this using this package called OpenCV. Okay, so we have to import OpenCV using this command import cv2, and the very first thing that we will see is how do we read and display an image in Python. Okay, using Python. Okay, so we will see how to read and display an image using Python. So like you read list of numbers, you read arrays or something. So you can also read images in Python. Okay, so let's have a look how we can do it. Okay, so what I need to do, I need to say, I need to call a function called cv2.imread. And here, if you want to read an image, what parameter you should give? Any ideas? Suppose you want to read an image. What should be given to the function? Obviously, path of the image. Okay, so where that image is present, that I need to give. So everyone is giving me the right answer. So I have a folder called images in the same directory. In that folder, I have multiple images, B1, B2, B3, and B4. So what I can do, I can say, okay, the path of the images is like this, B1 dot whatever is the extension, it's PNG, okay. Great. So this will actually give me the image. So if I just print image, what I'm getting is a list of numbers. So can you tell me what type of data is this, or what type of data structure it is in which this image is stored? How do we store an image? It's a matrix. Great, great, great. So everyone is saying it's a matrix. And what are the dimensions of the matrix? Any ideas? Okay, so if you have an image like this in which you have, let's say, hills followed by something, you must have seen that image has a given width, it has a certain height, and also if it is a colored image, it has certain channels also. We call this image as a RGB image. Okay, so it has three channels, one for red, one for green, and one for blue. And you must have heard about pixel values. So if I talk about, okay, this is a white pixel, then how do you represent a white pixel? A single pixel has three components, red, green, and blue. Let's say if a pixel is white, then this value will be 255, 255, and 255. Okay. If a pixel is red, then this one possible value can be, it will have a red component as, let's say, 200 or 255. Green component will be zero, blue component will be zero. So that's how a red pixel will look like. So each pixel is stored using, it's stored using three numbers. Okay, it is stored using three numbers. Okay, now you can see here we have actually a 3D array. Okay, if you want to see what is the shape of the array, what is the dimension of the array, you have W cross H cross 3, then there is a property of this image that's called shape. So if I say print image dot shape, you can see this is what, this is the width, this is the height, and this is the number of channels. Okay, so the shape property gives you how many pixel values, how many numbers you have to store that one particular image. Okay, and if you see the data type, although this looks like a list, so there is a special data type in Python that's called NumPy array. Okay, so anyone has heard about NumPy? So if you want to create an array in Python, you can create it using a NumPy array. So if I say np.array 1, 2, 3. So it's a 1D array. So can you tell me what is the shape of A? If I say what is A dot shape, so what it will be? It will be 3 comma, okay? It has just 3 elements, but suppose if I make this as a 2D array, okay? If I say, okay, let's make this array as a 2D array and 4 comma 5 comma 6. Can you tell me what will be the shape of A now? 3 comma 2, no, 2 comma 3. It will be rows followed by columns, okay? So the shape of array A is 2 comma 3. So that's what this array is. So numpy array has this particular shape, 2 comma 3. Similarly, you can make a 3D array. If I just make it like this, now it will have a shape 1 comma 2 comma 3. So similarly, I have a 3D array here that has a shape of 540 rows, 570 columns, and 3 is the depth. So each image is just a matrix of numbers. That's how the images are stored inside the computer. Okay. So print A will just print the values of this particular array. So this is a class in the NumPy module. If you want to make an array using NumPy, then you have to call the constructor of this class np.array. So array is a function inside the NumPy module, and here you pass in what data you should put in the array. Okay. So if I put what is A of 0 comma 1. So can you tell me what will be the output now? 0th row and the first column. So this value will be 2. Sorry, this should be, yes. Let me just make this as a 2D array, then it should be fine. So if I do print A of 0 comma 1, then this value is 2. So you are basically trying to index a particular element. Okay, so it's similar to arrays in C++ or arrays in Java. Great. So I hope you got a little bit idea about NumPy array. Now we are not interested in seeing the shape of the array. We want to actually see this particular image. So let us see how we can display that particular image. Display the image. Import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Okay, so I'm importing another library and I'm going to use the show function of that particular library because it displays the image inside the Jupyter notebook. Okay, so CV2 does not have a function to display the image inside the notebook only. So we will use another library called matplotlib, and it has a function called imshow that will display the image. Okay, so you can see this is the image that we are displaying. And if you just want to remove these numbers, okay. Right, Jatin, yes, you are right. So for that, what we can do is we can just try that also. So cv2.imshow, and here we can give some title and some image, and we can call this function cv2.wait. Okay, so let's do this thing. Okay, anyways, it doesn't matter. We will see that later. So what you can do is you can use matplotlib to display any image. Okay, so you have to call the function imshow, and that will actually display the image. Yes, and if you actually want to draw this output, then you have to call the function called plot.show. So what actually happens is, suppose you write 5 here. So Jupyter will give you the output 5, but that is not the true output unless you write a print statement. Okay, so if you say print 5, then this is a true output. So similarly, when you just call plot.imshow, this output will not be shown if you run this code through a command line. Okay. But if you call, call the plot.show function, only then this image will be actually displayed. So that's like a print function. Okay, so this one, calling this is quite important, and this will actually show the image on the screen. Now let us also see how is the original image. So this is how the original image is looking like, and you can see there is now slight difference in the image that we have displayed, and there is this original image. So can you find out what is the difference, especially in the eyes, and why this is happening? And anyone who can guess. So yes, there is some problem with the color. So now that problem is due to the way channels are organized in OpenCV and in Python. Okay, so when you use OpenCV, okay, suppose you have numbers 200, 140, these are the pixel values lying in the image. And when you use OpenCV, OpenCV thinks that the first channel is a blue channel, the next channel is a green channel, and the third channel is a red channel. Okay, but when we display the image using Matplotlib, Matplotlib thinks that the first channel is a red channel, the next channel is a green channel, and the third channel is a blue channel. Okay, so that means all the pixel values in blue are displayed as pixel values of red. This is what happens when you use Matplotlib. So any idea how we can fix this issue? Yes, so by default, OpenCV library reads the images in the BGR format. So any idea how we can fix that issue? Yes, so Kushal is giving me a correct answer. We actually need to convert from BGR color space to RGB color space. Okay, so we have to use a function that is called convert color. Okay. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's convert from BGR to RGB color space. So I can say image equals to cv2.convertColor in this particular image from cv2.color_BGR to RGB. Okay. Now you can see by using this function accepts the image and it accepts a color mode. Okay, so it's like a if else condition written inside this function. If the color mode is BGR to RGB, you apply this particular transformation. Okay, so this is actually a number. Okay, so this is actually a number. So inside the function, there is a code written like this. If this is equal to 4, then you apply the conversion from BGR to RGB. Okay, so this anything that is written in capital letters is actually a constant. Okay, so that's what we do here. Okay, you can just put the value 4 and it will still work. Okay, so if you say this is 4, then it will still work. Are you guys getting it? So the CV2, the convert color function has if else conditions here. It has different color modes from BGR to RGB, BGR to gray, RGB to gray, or all that stuff. So if you just say, okay, I want to convert from BGR to RGB, the color conversion code is 4, and that's how you will convert this image into a RGB image. Now this is looking fine. Okay. So what I want to do next is I want to suppose see the size of this image. Okay, so that we have seen. Now suppose I want to read all images in the directory. So any guesses how you can read all these images in the directory? We have a dog, we have a tortoise, and so on. So can anyone tell if I want to read, let's say, 100 images in the directory? Then what I can do? I can use a loop. Great. Yes. So we will try to loop over all the images in the directory and we will try to display them. Okay. So for that, we will use a module that is called OS module or the operating system module in Python, and that allows you to access different files on your system. So what I can say is I can say, okay, import OS. And when you use Linux or Mac, there are various functions, okay, like make directory, list directory. So one function that is particularly useful is list dir. So if I say, okay, give me the list of images in this particular directory, so you can see what I'm getting is, if I give the folder name, I get a name of all the images in a Python list. Okay, so I can say image names are this, and I can now iterate over all the image names for a file name in image names. What I can say, if file name ends in png, so f dot ends with png, because this is not a valid image file, so we can just see if the file name is ending with png, then we can just display that name. So let's print f. So now these are the files we actually want to read. So what we can do, we can instead of reading the names, we can read all these images using OpenCV. Okay, so for that we will need to create a file path. So file path will be like this: images / followed by the file name. Okay, and I can say image equals to cv2.imread file path, and I want to convert that image from BGR to RGB. So convert color. And here I can say, okay, BGR to, oh sorry, image, and here I give 4, and I can say plot dot im show image and plot dot show image. File underscore path. Sorry, plot dot show. This should be plot dot show. Okay. Now you can see we are able to read all the images from the particular file directory. Okay. So is this clear now? How do we read different images? Or what we can do, we can just make a function that will accept a file path and give us the corresponding image. Okay, so maybe let's make a function to do the work. So I can say, okay, let's put this whole code inside a function. That will be like more useful for us. And let me also print the shape of the image. Okay, so print I'm giving a title to the image, and I'm saying, okay, also show me the shape of the image in the title of that particular image. So it's this shape, this is having this shape, and this is having this shape, this is having this shape. So what we can do is, everyone please go through the code and see if you have any doubts in any line, you can just ask me. So f dot ends with is a function on the string. So file name is a string. And on the string object, you can just call this function if this string ends with .png, okay? So maybe I can give you one example. Let's say s equals to hello. I can check s dot ends with llo. So this will be true. If I say if this string ends with lle, it will be false. So what is the use of the constant for? So that actually is a number that is used internally by convert color to denote what type of conversion we want to make. Okay, so ideally you should write it like this: cv2 dot color underscore bgr to RGB. Okay, so there are multiple conversions. If you want to convert that image into a grayscale image, so you can use it like this. Okay, and here you can say CMAP is gray. This is a gray image. So now you can see this is actually a grayscale image. So what you can do is you can just change this color code to RGB. So RGB has a one particular code called 4. Gray will have a different code, and so that. So that's why we need to use this. So Vikas says got it. Kushal says got it. Great. Okay. So it's like an internal if else check that this function is making. Okay, if the color code is this, I will make this conversion. If the color code is this, I will make this particular conversion. Okay. So my next task is I want to make a collage. So everyone had seen a collage in their life. I want to make a collage of images like this, which means I want to combine 4 images into a single image. Okay. So let's see how we can do it. Let's come to image collage. Yes, it works in online. Okay. So suppose I want to create an image which is a red square of red. Okay, I want to create a red square. What I will do? I want to create a red square of size 100x100. Then what should I do? Suppose I want to create that image using a NumPy array. I can say, okay, there is an array called red that is a NumPy array of 100x100x3. And what should I do in this array? I can say, yes, np.zeros. So let me tell you what is this function zeros doing. So if I say, okay, I want an array of 10 zeros. Then if I just print red, that will be an array of 10 zeros like this. Okay. If I say, okay, give me an array of 5x5. Sorry, this should be like this. It will be array of zeros. Okay. And you can see the each element is a floating point number. If you want the data type to be an integer, you can say, okay, this is int. The data type is an integer. So we are creating a NumPy array, and it's an array of 5x5, and every element is an integer. Okay. So what we can do is, suppose I want to select some of these elements in this array, and I want to make them as 6. So what we can do, we can use an operation called slicing. Can anyone tell me the syntax? How we can just select this part of the array? So you will have to say, okay, in the red array, I have to select rows from 1, 2, 3. So I will say, okay, the number of rows I want to select is from 1, 2, 3, followed by a comma, followed by which columns you want to select. So columns is also from 1, 2, 3. Okay. So basically, but what happens is when you give the end value, you have to actually give one more than the ending value. So it will be like 3+1, 3+1. So it will be like 1 to 4 and 1 to 4. So it will start from 1 and it will end 1 index before ending value. So you have to give it as 1 to 4 and 1 to 4. So this will actually select this part of the array, and this operation is called slicing. So I can say, okay, what I can do is I can say, okay, in the red array, I can say sum of the pixels from first row to before the fourth row, sum of the pixels from first column before the fourth column, and I will just put them as, let's say, 6. Okay, now you can see what is happening. So you are painting these elements as 6. Okay, so if I make this array as a now this is a array with 3 channels. Okay. So what I will do is, So I think you got an idea. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make an array of 50 cross 50 cross 3. And in this array, as I said, the first channel is red channel and the last channel is RGB, blue channel. So what I will do, I will select all the rows, I will select all the columns, and I will select only the zeroth channel, and I will make this as, let's say, 200. Okay. So if you want to select all the rows, it will be just a colon. If you want to select all the columns, it will be a colon, and you can see. Okay. So this is how this array is going to look like. So that means you have a 3D matrix like this, in which you have 200 in the front channel in every number, and followed by a green channel that is all zeros, followed by a blue channel that is all zeros. Are you guys getting it? This means all rows, this means all columns, this means the zeroth channel. Okay. So what I can do is I can just display this on graph plot.imshow red, and you can see this is a red image that we have just generated using a NumPy array. So can you tell me, if I want to generate a green image, what I should do? Guys, can you tell me, if I want to generate a green image, what should be the change I should do? Select the channel as one. Yes. So this channel will be one. Great. And I can show you the green also. Great. So I think you guys are getting it. And maybe if you you can change the color to 250, it will be a different shade of green. Okay. You can change it to, let's say, 100. It will be a darker shade of red. And as you go towards 255, the colors will become brighter. And as you go towards zero, the colors will become duller. Okay. So if I just make it as all zeros, it will be a black. Everything zero is a black. Everything 255 is actually white. Okay. So this is red and this is green. Now suppose you want to combine these two arrays into one. You want to combine these two arrays. Okay. So I want to put something like this, red followed by green. Okay. So what we can do is we can just use a function called hstack, which will stack these two arrays into a single array. So I can say red and green array is nothing but np.hstack red and green and plot.imshow red green. You can see. So that means you are combining two arrays. Now, can you tell me, if you want to get something of this form, red, green, followed by green and red, what do you need to do? So we have already built this array. VStack. Great. So if I just do something like this, if I say, okay, image equals to np.vstack, vertically stack red, green and red, green. Okay. That will actually give me a pattern in which red and green are repeating on themselves. But what we want is we want something called a green red. Okay. So can you tell me how I can generate a green red from red, green array? Basically, I want to reverse all the columns. Okay. So if the numbers are like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I want to make this as 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How we can do that? Okay. So, suppose you have this Python array. If you want to, let me show you how you can reverse an array in Python. So if I say array equals to np.array 10, 15, 20, and if I say, okay, select all the elements of the array from start to end, this is what you will get. If I say, okay, take a jump of 2, this is what you will get. You will go from 10, you will take a jump of 2, you will go to 20. But if I say take a jump of -1, that will actually print all the arrays in the reverse order. So you are traversing the array by taking a jump of -1. So you start from 20 you go to 15, you go to 10. That's what we will do. So we will just reverse all the columns of the array. Okay, so I can say green, red is nothing but in red, green, you select all the rows, you select all the columns, but in the reverse order. Okay, and you select all the channels. And when you are doing stacking, image will be np dot b stack of red, green, followed by green, red. And here you can just print that particular image. Okay. Om, please repeat your question. Now you can see we have just built a pattern in an image, and this is nothing but a collage. Now you can combine all the elements of the animals, you can combine them into a collage. Now you know. Okay. Okay, so Om, I'm giving you the mic, you're raising hand, or you can just text me the question and I will answer. Okay, you just put the question again, I will answer. Green, red. Okay, green, red once again. All right, so guys, what happens is now red, green is a 3D array. Okay, it has rows, it has columns, it has channels. Okay, so I don't want to do anything with the channels. Okay, so I just put a colon here. I don't want to do anything with the rows, because if there is like this 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, if I want to reverse flip it, that means columns need to be flipped. So that means it should be like this 4 3 2 1 followed by 9 8 7 6. That's what you need to do. So that means I will not do anything with rows. So this is the rows part, this is the channels part, and this is the part for columns. So I want to select all columns, so I just put a colon here. But when you do this thing, slicing operation, array start, end, and so either you write it like this for a 1D array, or you write it like this if you want to specify the direction. So jump. So in the columns, I want to specify the direction. So I put one more colon here, and I put the direction as -1. Okay. So these are the, this is what I have specified here. Okay. Why did you place these red and green boxes in this particular way? So I just wanted to create a pattern like this. So that's why I placed it like this. Okay, I'm just showing you how you can work with NumPy arrays and do some slicing operations, and how you can make images on your own. Okay, so now what we can do is we can just quickly write some code that will combine these images into a collage form. Okay, so what we can say, okay, let's say images equal to, or let's say animals equals to, it's a array. Okay, and every time I read an image, instead of showing that particular image, I will just append that particular image in the animals array. So animals is an array, and I say animals dot append whatever image we have. And one more thing we should do, we should resize each image into the same form, into the same size. So image equals to cv2.resize. Here I give the image, and I give the size as, let's say, 100, 100. Okay. Sorry, append is a function, right? Now, if I just print animals, it's going to be a array of images. Okay. So if you want to make a collage now, let's make a collage. So I want to stack first two animals. So let's say animal 1 and 2, that will be np dot h stack. Can you tell me what it would be? Animals 0 and animal 1. Okay, and animal 3 and 4 would be like this, np dot h stack animal 2 and animal 3. And I can say collage equals to np dot v stack animal 1 2 and animal 3 4 plot dot I'm show collage, and plot dot show. Okay, animal is not defined. It should be animals, animals, animals. Now you can see we now have all the elements on a same collage. Okay. So quickly go through this code and see if anything is not clear. You can just ask me. Okay, that's what we have built. How we can put the fifth image in the center? Okay, so you are asking me the question from the assignment, right? So I am sure we'll just display this collage matrix. That's a NumPy array. Kushal, what you need to do is you need to come up with a formula that will actually help us to help you to get these particular rows. Once you have built this particular collage, you can just slice this part of the array and you can put this equal to the new image array. Okay. So for that you need a row column and this width and height that you can compute according to the constraints given in the question. And you can just put this equal to the new image and that can be done. Kushal says got it. Yes, Abhijit, in coming days, okay. Why I use the show function after image show. So as I told earlier, what happens is when you use plot.imshow, this will output the image on the Jupyter notebook. But when you try to execute this code through Python, it will not show anything unless you call the show function. Okay. It's similar to like this. If you print 5 here, you get 5 as the output. But if you want to actually print 5, you actually have to write print 5. Okay. So that output stays in the memory. So this output is not the true output. Okay. So it's the state of the memory that Jupyter notebook displays. Similarly, plot.imshow plots that in the memory. It comes on the screen only when you call the plot.show function. That's what we are doing. Okay. How to add padding? Good question. So Himanshu ne question pucha hai, padding kaise add kare. So main aapko ek example de deta hu. Let me create an image called. Let's say I want to add some white border in between these two. Okay, let's say I want to add a border that is 20 pixel thick and let's say it is of blue color. I want to add a blue border. Okay, so that's what Himanshu has asked. So what I need to create is I need to create an image which has these many pixels. So if I want to check how many pixels are these, okay, I can also check in these also. So let's try to do in this assignment. So print collage.shape. So shape is 200, 200. So I can say, okay, let me make a border that is equal to np.zeros. Suppose you want to put a boundary partition like this. Okay. So of one particular color. So let's say I want to put a black partition. So np.zeros, the length will be like this, 200. Okay. And the height would be, let's say 20, and channels would be 3. Okay. That's what I'm saying. And data type is uint. So you have an array of zeros. All right. So what I will do is I will place this border inside the, when I am going to stack these images, I can say, okay, put the border here. Right. So I'm putting a border here, right, in between these two. This is 100, this is 200. So I think they should be like this. 10 comma 20 comma 200, okay. Instead of stacking two arrays, I am now stacking three arrays. If I want to reduce the width, it will be like this. Yes, the number of rows should be 10. Okay. The number of columns should be 200. The number of channels should be 3. Same thing you can do for a vertical partition also. You can say, okay, I want to make another border. A border vertical that would be of the shape 10 comma 100 comma 3. And you can say border underscore vertical and border underscore vertical. Oh, 100 comma 10 comma 3. Okay, I will see. Okay, so that's not actually an issue. So we have to write some more carefully. But I think you're getting this, right? Okay, u int 8. So Kushal says, what is u int 8? Okay guys, you can use int data type, but what happens is this is memory efficient. Okay, so what you need to do is, if you see an image and if you say okay, each element of the image is of the data type int, then this int takes 32 bits and range of int is 2^32. If you say no, I will use u int 8, okay, that means this is unsigned int 8. Okay, so it is going to take 8 bits. And if you store an image that is going to have a size of 8 MB, and here you will have the range of 2^8, that is up to 255 you can store. And since you know the pixel values are always in this range 0 to 255, so we can actually use unsigned int 8 data type. That will, can you tell me how it will be helpful? How this data type will be helpful if I use uintdate? Suppose you have an image whose in which you are storing the data type in int. Okay, in int every integer takes, let's say, 4 bytes. That means 32 bits. Okay, if you use uintdate, every integer just take 8 bits. That means you are saving 4x more memory, 8x more memory. Okay, that is 1 byte. Yeah, 4x more memory. That means if you need 20 MB to store one image, you can store the same image using 4 MB data, and that's how these images are generally stored, and without loss of quality. Okay, so that's why uint 8 is preferred. And since data has a range of yes, that's why we are not using float also, okay, without loss of quality. So I'm just using it uint 8, 8-bit integer. Okay, got it. Because if you have like, let's say, 100 images in the memory and they are taking 1 GB, but if you use int 8, they will take 4 GB or 8 GB. Okay, that's the whole idea of taking uint 8. Okay, so I think you got familiar with the basics of OpenCV. How do we work with arrays? And now let's try to work little bit with images also. Okay, sorry, face images also. So what I will do is, I will Atul says, wish this class never ends. I hope so. So it means you guys are enjoying the session, right? Yes, I will try to put the recording. Okay, but it will take a couple of days, not in 2-3 days I'm not going to put, maybe in a week or so, okay, on CB YouTube channel. All right, so let's do one more project. And yes, notebook I will share, right? So notebook I will share. So maybe on the video, I will put the link of the notebook also. If we want to read a video file, then imread function can work. Okay, so let's try to work with videos. So probably not, but I will teach you how you can read a video from your camera, okay? So this time what I am going to do is, I am going to, instead of creating a notebook, I am going to create a Python file. That will be more helpful. I will execute it from command line because of some crashes that occur in Jupyter due to this. So let's say camera read.py. So it's now a Python file. So I'm going to say import cv2. And I'm going to try to read images from the camera. Okay. So what I will do, we will first create a camera object in OpenCV. So I can say camera equals to cv2.videoCapture. And here you have to give the index of the camera. Since my PC is connected to three cameras right now, two cameras, one is my external camera and one is my webcam. So I will say, okay, I will give the ID of the camera I want to capture. So this is my zeroth camera. And what I will do, I will say, okay, try to capture one image from the camera. Okay. Maybe we can also do it in notebook also. And here what I will do, I will click a picture from the camera. Okay. So how I can click that picture? By calling a function called read. I can say, okay, pick equals to camera dot read. Yes, IDs are in the form of indexes 0, 1, 2, right? So I will read a picture from the camera and I will close the camera. So how I can close the camera? I can say, okay, camera dot release. Then I can display the picture. I can say plot dot im show pic, and here I can import matplotlib. Okay, now you can see if I see what I am doing is I'm reading picture from the camera. Now this read function actually returns, if I just print what is pic. So this read function actually returns two things. The first is a Boolean variable, that's true. And second is an array. So instead of saying, okay, read the pic, I can say, okay, I'm getting two things. One is my Boolean variable success. That means that particular picture was captured successfully or not. And here I can say if I got the success, that means my camera was able to capture the picture, then I can say, okay, show that pic, okay? Print pic, or I can say plot dot imshow pic, and I can just convert that into Okay, now you can see this is in the BGR format. I can convert that pic into RGB format also. Okay, cv2.convertColorPic, and here I can say cv2 dot, or I can just put 4, and you can see. Okay. So you can see we are able to capture a picture from the camera. Okay.